All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Wu Truong. He's the CEO of Aridis Pharmaceuticals. And Wu, it's good to have you back. How are you?
Steve, thank you. Great to be back with you.
Yeah. Exciting announcement out from the company today. We'll get to that in just a second, but it all relates to AR-703. So maybe you could just let everyone know a little bit more about AR-703.
Yeah, you know, Steve, this is one of the two antibody component on an antibody cocktail. Again, discovered directly from convalescent COVID patient that neutralizes a different part of the virus that others have not been able to develop drug candidates for. And this part of the virus actually enables the antibody to be broadly reactive to not only all the variants of COVID-19 virus, but also the Omicron, and also a bunch of other coronaviruses that have been associated with past pandemics. So this is quite an exciting new discovery.
Yeah, can you sort of explain that a little bit more so people understand? Because the key to the news release is that you're finding that it does bind to Omicron and the other variants, as well as like the common cold and things like that. Can you kind of explain that to us?
Yes, you know, you know, as with any viruses, there are places where the virus don't change despite all of the mutations that give rise to new variants. So what we seek to do is to go after those more what we call conserved regions. And when you find it, then that drug should be able to be broadly reactive to all kinds of related coronaviruses, including the common cold coronavirus. And this is pretty much what AR-703 can do. The other neat thing about this discovery is that this conserved region where 703 is targeting is also critically involved in the actual entry of the virus into human cells to amplify themselves. So we are now attacking another major mechanism that the virus uses to infect humans. And so what we have now in this cocktail is not only this antibody, but also the traditional antibody targeting the place where all the other commercial antibodies target. So we have two antibodies targeting two distinct mechanisms of action. So it's very difficult for the virus to generate resistance response against a cocktail like this. That's why we're excited.
Yeah, and Wu, I understand that it's been also engineered to be long lasting as well.
It is, Steve. You know, we, with our other molecule, the antibacterial program that's in phase 3 testing now, we have shown that you can take an antibody and change it a little bit so that it will actually be long acting. Instead of lasting about, on average, 3 to 4 weeks in terms of when it is reduced to half-life, it is now engineered to have 3 to 4 months half-life. So that means that a single shot, our data show that you could actually have drug in the patient for up to a year or longer and protect them. And so this is quite an exciting achievement as well. So this would be long-acting drug that you can use safely because they're fully human antibody. You can use it in treatment mode and you can use it in prevention mode.
Okay, so that's obviously the news out today, Wu. So where do you go with this now? What's sort of the next step so investors understand?
Well, you know, Omicron has really rendered a lot of the antibody therapy essentially ineffective or mostly ineffective. So now it actually has hit a reset button on a bunch of drug developers like ours. So now with this new cocktail, we are going to move very fast and enter it in clinic, hopefully sometime in the late second quarter. And then the clinical development will also happen in COVID speed. As you know, clinical trial can be done very fast. So we still expect this drug to be possibly available in 2023.
All right, Wu, we'll leave it there. Congratulations on this. You know, there's a lot of people that are suffering with this all around the world. So it's important for studies like this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Steve. We're excited about this new finding.
All right, there's Wu Truong. He is the CEO of Aridis Pharmaceuticals.